now that my E-series relay is all set up, I wonder if I can check out the metered values from here. You would think that with 8 buttons on the front panel, one of them would let me look at metered values.
You know you can do that, right?
Seriously?
Completely.
I didn't know that you could do that. The front panel's always been a bit of a mystery to me.
You know, it's not that hard.
Says you. Do you think you can show me?
So you know you've got 8 buttons and a display on the front of the E-Series relay. The bottom row is labeled, and the top row is context sensitive, and the labels are here on the display. Generally, these are arrows for you to navigate in and out of the menus. Here's the cool thing. The menu structure here is identical to the one in PowerPort E, so you can change protection settings, reset trips, and monitor values without needing to connect back up to your computer. I wouldn't do the entire commissioning from here, but it's pretty convenient for simple changes.
Why don't we do a few just for fun?
Fun?
Relays are fun.
Okay, we can look at changing protection parameters, viewing metered values, resetting after a trip, and some setting COM addresses, and turning maintenance mode on and off.
So let's say, hypothetically.
Hypothetically?
Hypothetically, that I wanted to change pickup on 51P1. How would you do that?
Now remember, it's just like PowerPort E. You would go into your menu and you would scroll down to protection parameters and you would enter protection parameters and go down to set one. Go into set one and choose the current protection, which on the display is listed as iProtect. And then scroll down to 51P1. Oops, too far, back up. Enter 51P1 and then scroll down to the pickup setting. And then enter the pickup. To change the default setting, you enter there and you see the pickup. You see that there's a key sign. That means that the password needs to be entered. Then you're given a menu that you can change the setting. And you have the up and down keys so that you can enter the setting you would like. And you click OK. You're brought back to the other menu and notice this asterisk. That indicates that there is a setting that is changed that has not been saved. In order to save it, you can click OK again. Then it'll ask you if you want to save it. You can click Yes. The hourglass indicates that it's saving the parameter. And now that it's saved, the asterisk is gone. You can exit back out just the way you came in, back to the main menu.
That's pretty cool.
But you wanted to view the metered values.
I know how to do that in PowerPort E. If the menu structure is the same, then I would say menu, operation, and metered values.
Would you like to see a shortcut?
Well, of course.
If you go back to the home screen, one of the soft keys is labeled MEAS for measured values. All you have to do is hit that button.
That is way easier. I'll have to remember that. Oh, hey, all the parameters are listed here, and I can use the right arrow to go into any of them, and we can view all the details here. So let's say my relay trips and I wanted to reset it. How would I do that?
Well, you can navigate to the reset menu, menu, operation, down to resets.
Why am I sensing a butt here? There's a shortcut key, isn't there?
Yeah.
Well, show us the shortcut key.
Don't you want to show the viewers the long way to practice your menu navigation?
No. The viewers know that the navigation is the same as PowerPort E. They want to see the shortcut key.
You want to see the shortcut key. So the shortcut key to get to the reset menu is this key here. We go back to the main menu and we go to the acknowledge and reset. From here, you can scroll up and down to pick what you would like to reset. That could be relay outputs, LEDs, comms, or the trip command.
How about all of the above?
You can do that too. That's the first option here. Typically, this is password protected, and you'll see the key icon right here. However, since we put the password in a minute ago, the icon turns into a wrench that I can just go in and reset it. And you'll actually be prompted again just to be safe.
I want to change my comms addresses. How would I do that?
This one's a little tricky. It's got a couple of steps. Let's start by making sure that the correct communication protocol is selected. If you haven't given it your password, you will be prompted.
So, menu, device planning, where are you going up?
I'm going up because I happen to know that the device planning menu is at the bottom of the menu, so going up wraps around.
Oh, very nice. Okay.
So it's a shortcut when dealing with the front panel.
Okay, and then after that, communication protocol.
Oh, that's too long. I'm going to go wrap around again.
Okay, let's do Modbus TCP IP.
As we noticed, the key is there, so it's going to require a password. Now I'm giving the option of 61850, DNP, or Modbus TCP.
DNP is one of the new features, isn't it?
Correct.
Okay, so go ahead and hit OK and see the little star.
Notice the asterisk. I'll hit OK again to save that.
All right, what's next?
Well, once you've selected the communication protocol within the device planning, it will show up in the device parameters. Underneath the TCP IP settings will be Modbus. However, first what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to set the IP address of the relay in order to use Modbus TCP. So we'll go into TCP IP, we'll go into the configuration, and then we'll scroll down, and there's the IP address. And again, just like all the other settings, we'll hit the wrench, and we'll be able to change the IP address.
Typically, this is password protected too, right?
Correct. So then, since I'm not changing it, there's no settings to change. And once the IP address is set up, we can go into the Modbus settings. And in here is where we would enter the unit ID and the TCP port configuration and the port number. And then your communication should be set up.
That's awesome. You know what? This is actually not that hard.
Yeah, that's because the E stands for easy.
Actually, I think it stands for Eaton.
Whatever.
Okay. Last one. Let's turn maintenance mode on. So you can start off by...
Wait, hang on. It's worth mentioning what maintenance mode is so that we're all on the same page. Maintenance mode is a temporary state that limits arc energy to the circuit. The state is controlled by settings loop 2, which should have been programmed previously based around an arc flash study. Now, there's a trick to this one. You have to set it up to let you activate maintenance mode from the front panel. It's a one-time thing, so once you have it set up, then you'll be able to change maintenance mode with the push of a button. So we'll navigate to the menu, and the PowerPort e-menu for this is Service, and Maintenance Mode Manually. And normally, this is going to be password protected, but since we've already been authenticated, I'm just going to go ahead and hit the little wrench down here. And if I go down to, I can scroll down to active and hit OK. And it's going to prompt me when I hit yes. So now that we're all set up, we should be able to change maintenance mode manually from here on out.
You're on a roll. Keep going.
Okay, so I know that I can now activate or inactivate maintenance mode from the main mode manually menu, where we are right now, but there feels like there should be an easier way. There's probably a shortcut key that I can use if I'm on the home screen, right?
Which button do you think it is?
Well, let's see. Let's go back to the home screen. Gee, I don't know. Probably this one here that says Mate, short for Maintenance Mode, right? There we go. You can see that there's only one option on the screen. It says that Maintenance Mode manually is active, so we're all good.
So you only see that wrench or the password prompt if you have Maintenance Mode set to manual. If you set it to be controlled by a digital input or over comms, you won't be able to edit it from the front panel.
So thanks for that. Now I'm all ready to use my E-Series relay from the front panel.
No more questions?
No more questions.
If you have any more questions, please contact Eaton's customer success team.
I'll put the number on the screen below.
Thanks for choosing E-Series.
The relay you can rely on.